Hello friends, welcome to Global Tech Learn. In today's video, we will learn case statement in SQL Server. Case statement is like if else statement that we can use to apply condition on the data values. We can use case statement in different ways, and in today's video we will cover case statement with a simple case as well as how we can use it as a searched case. Then also we will see multi-level nested case statement, and thereafter we will see how we can use case statement in order by as well as in group by, and then finally we will see how we can use case statement to update the data in the tables. Now let's jump into the SQL Server Management Studio, and here we can see we have employee tables. Let's look at the data first, and here we can see under employee tables we have employee ID, employee name, employee designation, department ID, then supervisor, and thereafter we have gender. Now let's start with the simple case statement. Let's say in this data we want to see the gender with the complete name. That means here we have gender M, that is male, and then we have F for the female, but we want to populate the complete name, that is male or female, for each record. So for that we can add one case statement, select case gender when it's M, then we want to be print as male, and when it is F, then we want to print as female. And then we can add else as well, and that means if none of this value is found, then what we have to print. So let's say we want to print as not available, and then we can end the statement with end keyword. And let's name it as this gender, and thereafter we want to print all the fields from the table. So let's put a star over here, and then from the table name, that is employees. Now let's execute this statement, and here you can see in result set wherever we have gender M, then we are getting male, and wherever we have gender as F, we are getting female. So here you can see in case statement, this is like if else statement in programming language, where we can provide the condition, that is case, on the field name, that is gender, and then for each value we can add when. If it is value is M, then it should print male. When the value is F, then it should consider it as a female. And then we can provide the else part, where if none of the value is found, then it should go into the else statement, consider that as a not available, and then finally we can close the case statement with the end keyword. So this is the example of simple case statement. Now let's go with searched case statement. It works little bit differently, where instead of defining the field for the case just after the case, like here, we put it under the when scope. Say for example, instead of defining gender in the after the case, I will provide it over here. So case when gender is equals to M, then it should be male. Then when gender is equals to F, then it should be female, else not available. Now let's execute this statement, and here you can see we are getting same result set, but the difference in the case statement is the gender we have provided instead of the case statement. In real business environment, we mostly use searched based case statement, because most of the time we use multiple fields or combination of the fields to apply case statement. So here you can see while defining gender after the when statement, we can add more conditions within the one case statement. So let's say in this searched based case statement, we want to add one more filter where along with the gender, we want to check the department. So let's say if department is equals to corporate, then we want to populate a value as a male leadership. And wherever there is a department is corporate along with the gender female, then we want to populate female leadership. So in this case, we want to apply if condition based on two fields, that is department and gender. So in that case, along with the case when gender is equals to male, we can add one more condition, that is and department ID is equals to corporate. Then we want to populate male leadership. And similarly, when gender is equals to female and department is equals to corporate, then we want to call it as a female leadership. Else not available. And let me name it as a gender leadership. Let's execute this statement. And here you can see we have corporate with M, so we have male leadership, and wherever we have corporate with F, we have female leadership. And here we have applied the condition based on two columns, that is gender and department. In this way, we can add multiple columns to make it as one condition to calculate the derived value. Now, as the same statement, we can write in different way as well. Let's say we want to achieve the same requirement, that is, what is the leadership type, whether it is male leadership or female leadership. But we want to use nested case statement instead of putting all the condition in one statement. So in that case, we can add like case when gender is equals to male. Then we can add another case statement. That is case when department ID is equals to corporate, then male leadership, and else NA. Then next is when gender is equals to female, and under that we want to again add another case statement, that is case when department is equals to corporate, then female leadership, else let's put it as a NA, then and thereafter we had to put else statement for the top level case statement, that is again NA, and let's close this statement with the end. And yeah, we have missed the then here also, we have missed the then. Yeah, that's it. Let's execute this query now. And here you can see wherever there is a corporate department with the M, then we have male leadership. And wherever there is a corporate with the F, we have female leadership. So here you can see we have used the case statement within the another case statement. This is called the nesting of the case statement. In this way, we can apply multi-level case or else statements based on the requirement. Now let's clear this window and let me add one case statement to derive the department ID. So here under department, we can see we have corporate, finance, marketing, and let's give them a code. Let's say case on department ID when it is corporate. Let's give it number as 1, and when it is marketing, then let's number it as 2, and when it is finance, then let's make it as a 3, else 9. And let's name it as a department code. Now let's execute this statement. And here you can see we have all the records along with the department code. And it has been populated based on the given condition in case statement. So if it is corporate, then it should be 1. When it is finance, then it should be 3. And if it is marketing, then 2. Now let's say I want to apply an order by on this result set based on the department code. But here we have department, that is something calculated field from the case statement. So we can use case statement in order by as well. So for that we can add order by, and we can provide the same case statement over here. And now let's execute this. And here you can see the result set has been sorted based on the department code. And we can use case statement in group by as well. So for that, let's try with one example. Here you can see under designation, for broker you can see there are some typo in the record number 8, where we can see there is a BROKER. It should be KER. So we can clean this up using the case statement. So let's populate the corrected value. So for that, let's add case statement, case, that is based on designation. When it is broker, then we have to consider it as a broker, that is KER. Else it should be the original designation, as the remaining values are correct. And let's end this statement and give it alias as Desig for now. Now let me execute these. And here you can see for the broker we are getting broker, that is corrected value, and remaining values are as populated as is. Now let's try to apply group by on this result set. So for that we can apply group by. Now let's say if I want to group by based on the designation, but since I have typo in one of the value for the broker, so it will populate a separate value. Let's see that the result set. So for that, group by designation, and for now let me comment this out and let's see how many records we have for designation. So here you can see for broker we are getting 2 records, that is one for another broker. So now we want to merge this based on the calculated value, that is Desig. So we can use this expression. So let me add this instead of this designation. And same expression I can use in group by as well. And this should work fine. So let me execute this. And now you can see both the type of broker has been merged. Let me clean this. Now you can understand it properly. So we have applied the condition based on designation. Wherever there is a BROKER broker, it should show as a BROKER. And same condition we have used within group by as well. So in this way we have seen we can use case statement in select, in group by, in order by, almost in all the blocks of the query. Now let's use the case statement with the update statement. Let me populate the value for the table. And here you can see in designation, as we know, we have one record as a typo and that we want to fix. So to correct this spelling mistake, we need to apply update statement. So for that we can use update, and we want to apply update, and we want to update the employees table, and we want to update the designation. And here we want to apply the case statement that we already have written here. So let me add this. So we want to apply the designation. There is a typo. So set designation is equals to case, that is designation. When it's a broker, then it should be considered as a broker, that is KER. Else it should be the original designation. Now let's execute this statement, and now we can see, let me execute this statement, and here we can see we have the corrected value. So in this way we can use the case statement in update command as well. So this is how we can use case statement in the SQL query, various blocks, that is in select statement we can use in order by or group by, and same case statement we can use in different ways like simple case statement, then we have searched case statement, and we can use multi-level case statement where we nest the case statement within the another case statement. And also we have seen we can use case statement within the update command as well. I hope you have learned case statement now from this video. And if you have any questions or query, you can put in a comment window and I will try to answer that. This is all for this video, and see you in next video.